Today, let's talk about a model called stand-in. This isn't exactly a new model. We've covered it before. So why are we bringing it up again? Well, the original stand-in was fine-tuned based on YOLO 2.1. But this new tuning work is based on the updated YOLO 2.2. We have a lot of content to cover today involving three versions of the workflow. The first version is Kijai's original workflow. Now, Kijai hasn't officially released this workflow through standard channels yet, but he provided a reference workflow. Here we have a reference image, and based on our prompt, it generates a corresponding video of that character. Take a look. The overall effect is actually quite good. However, Kijai mentioned that he was very unsatisfied with this workflow, and we'll explain why in a moment. The second version is a workflow I optimized myself. The prompt hasn't changed, but the reference image looks different. I've pulled the camera back significantly, so we're seeing the full body of this beauty. We all know that the resolution occupied by the face has a huge impact on the final character consistency. If we use a reference image like this, the final generation quality is very high. But as we expected, the character consistency actually drops to some extent. That leads us to the third version of the workflow. We use the same prompt and the same reference image, but let's look at the final generated video. Look at that, isn't it much better? Both the overall video quality and the character consistency have been vastly improved. Some might ask, is it just because the generated video has a closer framing? So, we made another version for you. This one uses the same prompt and reference image, but look at the result. The character consistency is still handled incredibly well. I think the standing model tuning on YOLO 2.2 is actually done very well. So, what technologies do these three workflows use? How are they constructed? And what are the key points of improvement in each version? Let's break it down for you in detail. Currently, Kijai's YOLO video extension already supports this model. Now, even though we can't get his official workflow, you can find relevant content in a discussion thread. In his reply, Kijai provided a workflow link. He mentioned that this is his workflow, but he is very unhappy with it. He thinks there are issues with the step settings. He also said this workflow is provided as a starting point for everyone to tune. Regarding the model download, currently we can only get the FP16 version and it exists in the form of YOLO. This is almost identical to the YOLO 2.1 version. Essentially, we have two models here. One for high noise sampling and one for low noise sampling. I've also built this workflow on Running Hub. Running Hub is a fantastic online platform for comfyUI because whenever new tech or models appear, they update immediately. You can use the invite link in my video description to register for Running Hub, which will get you 1,000 free points. Plus, logging in daily gives you another 100 points, so you can try these workflows yourself. Next, let's look at the first workflow, Kijai's original version. I won't go into the basic structure in detail because the layout is quite chaotic and hard to trace. I'll explain the workflow composition in detail when we get to the second version. Let's just talk about why he was dissatisfied with this version. It is basically a hybrid version. There are a few weird things here. First, for the acceleration model, he set it to 3.0 here. I didn't dig into the reason. I just ran it. And the results were okay, but that setting feels a bit baffling. The second point is the model loading. I don't know if this was intentional or an oversight, but for the high noise model, he used the official comfyUI model, while for the low noise model, he used his own. Because of these reasons, you'll find it looks very much like a mishmash model. It just doesn't feel pure or comfortable. I think that is the main reason Kijai didn't officially release this workflow. What you are seeing now is my optimized version. First, I optimized the structure to make it look much clearer. I also made some slight changes to the model application. But please note that the key points and logic in every part are exactly the same as Kijai's. So, we'll use this workflow to give you a detailed breakdown. If you go back and look at Kijai's original workflow later, it is the same thing. The first part is model loading. We are loading quite a few models here. First is the acceleration model. Here I am using the LightX to V1022 version acceleration LoRa, and this is a four-step version, which is slightly different from Kijai's original. Then we have the standing models. These are the two provided by Kijai, then our VAE. For the main model, I am using the YOLO 2.2 model provided by Kijai, not the official original one, because the whole workflow is implemented using Kijai's nodes. After that, we enable block swapping. The second part is image processing. The logic here is also the same as Kijai's, but I replaced some nodes. First, we remove the background from the reference image. After that, I fill the background with white, but before that, I use the pad method to resize it. The resize dimension is fixed at 512 by 512, so you'll see a standardized image like this. After that, we convert it into our latent space using the OneVideoEncode node. The most important node here is this one, OneVideo adds standing latent. Essentially, it adds the standing constraints to our traditional latent. First, we generate an empty latent with a resolution of 832 by 480. Then, we use this node to add the OneVideo latent into this empty latent. When sampling, we use the output from this node. The entire sampling setting is the same method Kijai used. We have a total of 6 steps. The first 3 steps perform high noise model sampling, and the last 3 steps perform low noise model sampling. After sampling, we get a video like this. Take a look. The character consistency is quite good. In this version, we didn't do any special settings, and the weight wasn't set to 3.0. Both models are basically from the same system, Kijai's version. So that is the origin of the second version. Now let's talk about the downside of the second version. As I mentioned before, the amount of resolution the character's face occupies significantly affects the consistency of the final video. Let's run a test. Using the same workflow, we select different reference images. Look at this first reference image. It is a close-up, almost a facial shot, and the facial features are very distinct. Let's look at the final generated result. The consistency is extremely strong, right? If you compare the character to the reference image, it is very obvious they are about 95% similar. Now, let's pull the camera back. The reference image is now a waist-up shot. Let's look at the result. Although the consistency is still relatively strong, it is clear that the resemblance isn't as close anymore. Now, let's pull the camera back even further. Look at this reference image. The face takes up a very small amount of resolution. Let's look at the result. The facial consistency is very low here. We can only say the vibe is roughly correct, but if you look closely at the facial features, there are huge changes. This is the problem that exists with the traditional stand-in method. Some people ask, how do we solve this? We've actually discussed this issue before, but it wasn't as obvious in 1.2.1. Let's go back and look at the standing GitHub page. There is a section where they first thank Kijai for supporting the model, but they believe Kijai's image pre-processing is unsuitable. So, they developed a separate extension. What you are seeing now is the page for this extension. The installation process is quite simple. You just need to clone it and install the dependencies. After that, let's look at what the improved workflow looks like. We still use that reference image with the distant framing. For processing, we don't use background removal anymore. Instead, we use the official image pre-processing node we just mentioned called Stand-in Preprocessor. We need to load a model here, which is a common YOLO model. Connect the reference image, set the resolution to 512, and you can leave the other parameters at default. After running this, we get an image like this. This reference image essentially crops out everything except the face. We simply retain the character's face and hairstyle, no matter what your original image looks like. This processed image focuses purely on the face. The subsequent processing is exactly the same. Now, let's look at the result. This is beautiful. Even though the face occupied a small part of the original resolution, the consistency we get is still excellent. Some might say, is it just because your generated video has a closer framing, making the character consistency feel better? So let's modify the prompt. This prompt was generated by a WAN 2.2 prompt generator I introduced previously. This prompt fits the WAN 2.2 standards very well. It has keywords, character descriptions, and action descriptions. Let's look at the final generated effect. The prompt focuses on a character painting in a studio. We described paint splatters on their clothes, dust flying in the studio air, and clearly described the character holding a brush and painting on a canvas. Look at that. The overall framing is pulled back quite far, but notice the character consistency, it is still perfect. So this is the workflow I suggest everyone use in the end. You can do more testing on your own. Just like Kijai said, he provided a starting point, and what we need to do is explore various feasible solutions based on that starting point. So what are you waiting for? Hurry up and try it yourself. Follow me and become someone who truly understands AI.